What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back again with the second tutorial in PL SQL stored procedure series. As we have already covered the introduction of stored procedures, thus today in this PL SQL tutorial, we will learn how to create PL SQL stored procedures in Oracle database with the help of an easy to understand example. So without further ado, let's start and learn how to create PL SQL stored procedures in Oracle database. In the demonstration, I will show you the very simple example which will teach you the creation process of stored procedures in Oracle database. Here is a very simple stored procedure with name PR_RebellionRider. You can name your procedure whatever you want as it is completely user defined. This is a procedure with no parameters. As you can see here, we don't have any parameter list followed by the name, which indicates that this PL SQL procedure does not accept any parameters. Moving on, in the body of this stored procedure, I have declared two variables of varchar2 data type for holding the strings. Here, the first variable will hold the name and second will hold the name of the website. Then, inside the execution section, I have printed the value stored into these two variables with a formatted string using the DBMS output statement. As you can see in this code, unlike PL SQL functions, we don't have any return clause. This is because PL SQL stored procedures does not return any values like functions. So let's go ahead and compile this code and check whether it works. Then we will see how we can call the procedure to see the result. Procedure PR_RebellionRider compiled successfully with no errors, which means we are good to go. Now that we have created and compiled our stored procedure successfully, next we will learn how to call it and see the output from the procedure. The procedure which we just compiled is simply displaying a formatted string which is its output. So, how can we see that output? There are multiple ways of calling a procedure. Similar to function, we can call a procedure using an anonymous as well as a named PL SQL block. Or we can use an execute statement just to see the output of our PL SQL procedure. So let's start with the simplest way of checking the output, or say executing the procedure, which is the execute statement. But first, let me close this script output and open a fresh worksheet. Great. Yes. You simply have to write the keyword execute followed by the name of your procedure. Or if you are lazy like me, then simply write the first four letters of the keyword execute, which is EXEC. Both these statements will do the same work. Let's check. But before executing these two statements, we have to set the server output on so that we can see the result. Done. Now let's execute our procedure call statements one by one. Here is the result of our PL SQL procedure from the first statement. Now let's check the second one. And here we are. Both the results are the same. This is the first way of executing a PL SQL procedure. Another way is to directly call the procedure inside your anonymous or named PL SQL block. Let's check out that also. But before that, once again, let's close this script output and clear the screen. Done. That is the execution section of the simplest anonymous PL SQL block, which consists of only one executable statement, which is the name of our PL SQL stored procedure, or say the procedure call statement. On execution of this PL SQL block, we will see the output from the mentioned procedure. So let's execute. And here is the result. Always remember, unlike PL SQL function, you cannot use a procedure as a right-hand side operand to the assignment operator to assign its value to a variable. In simple words, value returned by the procedure cannot be assigned to a variable. Similarly, you can call a stored procedure using a named PL SQL block, and that will be your homework. Write a stored procedure and try calling it using a named PL SQL block such as a PL SQL function or a trigger. You can send answers to me on my email or on my social media like Twitter or Facebook. All the links are in the description. That's it for this tutorial on how to create a PL SQL stored procedure with no parameters. Stay tuned, as in the next tutorial, we will see some more examples of how to create stored procedures in Oracle database. Also, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. You can also help others in learning as well as support me and my channel by sharing this video on your social media with your friends. You can also follow me on my social media for more regular updates. All my contact links are in the description. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.